If there's one thing Ubiquiti is known for, it's Wi-Fi. Specifically, making really fast, high-density Wi-Fi in a form factor that's relatively affordable, at least when you put it in the scope of the crazy expensive enterprise solutions of today. Contrary to that is this. Ubiquiti's new Cloud Key Enterprise. This, as far as I can tell, is the single most expensive Ubiquiti product at a whopping $5,000. Can you see me here? The set wasn't exactly built for items this large. We've got rails. Yep, this is rack mountable. We've got two power cables. More on that later. Oh my God, that's heavy. Here's a little size comparison. We've got a normal Cloud Key Gen 2. And we've got a Cloud Key Gen 2 Plus. It's a little bit bigger. I don't know if it's really fair to call this thing a key anymore. This is the president's key. Unlocks all of the locks in the kingdom. With the fascia off on the front here, we've got a standard 1.3 inch Ubiquiti LCM, which is the little screen they have on the front. We've got a 1 gig RJ45 port, and they've also got a 10 gig SFP port. Now I talked to the Ubiquiti folks and asked them, really? Is this thing ever gonna pull 10 gig? But as I expected, it's more so just because this is designed to be put in a, you know, a very large or enterprise deployment, and you're probably gonna wanna plug this thing in with fiber, and if you just had an RJ45, it would be kind of annoying. Around the back, that's a dedicated management port, something we have not seen on a Unify class product. And then on this side, we've got another thing I'm super stoked about, two removable, redundant, normal-ass AC power supplies. You know, on a $1,500 switch, like say the Enterprise XG24 or the Enterprise 48 PoE, those should have these, and I really hope that this is where the future is headed for Ubiquiti. You can get replacement power supplies for the Cloud Key Enterprise from support, and they are working on adding them to the store, which is great. Did they put wheels on this thing? Holy they put wheels on the thing. It slides so nice. Look at that. I'm an adult, okay? I can do what I want. Got my handy dandy custom screwdriver I built at LTX. You can at least get a solid color now on LTT store. Realistically, you're probably never gonna open this thing. I'm a little surprised. Like, I knew it was just gonna be a server. I just didn't expect it to be so kind of off the shelf. You see that right there? What the heck is that? That's an SFP. And for the uninitiated, that SFP is the front 10 gig port. So this is just like an internal pass through. I'm gonna take this off for sure. But look at that. It's literally just a dual port SFP 10 gig card. This is a pushy thing. It's a release. Holy sh**. That's smart and also easily serviceable. They're using high quality components. So for your $5,000, you're not getting like no name RAM. It's actually a Samsung DDR4 stick of memory. Kingston SATA SSD over here is, well, it's a Kingston SSD. I mean, it's an OEM one, but it's not, you know, no name brand, whatever. Oh, look at that. You see that right there? It's an IPMI BMC chip like you would see in a server. Or maybe when you connect to this management port, it's just giving you like a standard IPMI interface. Being able to like remotely power cycle this thing would be sick, and something I've had to do on my Cloud Keys, but couldn't because it was remote. Now, speaking of CPU, this is a 16-core Xeon SP5218. The MSRP of this chip is around $1,500. And now that I've seen that it's basically an OEM server with the Unify software on it, you know, there's two sticks of DDR4, there's a CPU, there's a CPU cooler, there's the motherboard, all the fans, the two power supplies, the dual 10 gig NIC, well, that $5,000 price point starts to make a little bit more sense. I mean, at least $1,500 of it is the CPUs. I guess I should put this thing back together and try it out, but not before telling you about today's sponsor, Seasonic.
Thanks to Seasonic for sponsoring this video. Seasonic's Focus GX750 watt gold power supply is a good choice for mid-range systems at a great price. Featuring a fully modular interface paired with hybrid fan control to control overall fan noise and fluid dynamic fan bearings. Focus GX achieves an 80 plus gold rating with 90% efficiency at 50% system load, backed by a 10-year warranty. Learn more about them at seasonic.com or through the links below.
We are gonna need. If I was gonna adopt all of this stuff on a computer, I'd need to connect to it. But it's a lot easier to do on a phone because this has Bluetooth. So if we go to the Unify app, look at that. Wow, a pretty animation. Cloud Key Enterprise. I'm gonna call it, I feel like a key is disingenuous now, so I'm gonna call it the Cloud Key Enterprise. Okay, all of our devices are detected. Great, I didn't break anything. So it needs an update. In theory though, this should update like a lot faster. I mean, on a cloud key, usually it takes a couple minutes to stop, update, turn back on, figure stuff out. Okay, that was definitely faster. Maybe the update wasn't super noticeably faster, but once Unify OS was loaded, the network app went from starting to started in like a second. It just seems way more responsive. But I mean, that responsiveness is nice. I mean, we use a Cloud Key Gen 2 Plus like this, which has the same CPU as the small one, just with a bit more RAM, with around 100 Unify devices, so that's switches and access points, and around 300 to 700 clients, depending on the time of day. And you can tell sometimes when the Cloud Key is like, ugh. You apply a switch configuration change, and it might take 10 seconds or 15 seconds, or maybe a minute to actually propagate. So having a lot more compute just in terms of the responsiveness would be nice. And it's something I've desired for in the past. We're definitely gonna deploy this. What does Ubiquiti IPMI look like? Look at that! It's a totally normal IPMI. Health is good. We've got postcode logs, which is great. This is all pretty standard stuff for IPMI. Holy shit, there's a KVM. No way. No way! In theory, you can do anything you want in here. But you probably shouldn't. I wouldn't mess around with this, but it is helpful to see at least what the system is doing. These are the kind of enterprise features that something like this needs. If I run a speed test now, we should see the speed test traffic. 500 megabit, look at that, down. 600, ooh. Yeah, there's some new insights. The Wi-Fi insights are definitely new. They've got a coverage helper tool that just shows you all of the signal strength of your various devices to tell you if your AP density is good enough. They've got this connectivity thing that shows you problematic clients. You can see an environment scan that shows all of the nearby access points and the channels they're using. It's pretty much all I would expect to see. I'd really like to see SNMP so you could monitor this machine a little easier, but in terms of being able to access the things you would want to access in an IPM, power controls, virtual KVM, serial over LAN, and manual network settings, it's pretty much there. I can even test latency. Here we go. There you go. So you can see that this is to this phone in my hand right now. Oh, what if I wanted to see maybe my laptop's ping? Click on the laptop, test latency. There you go. Super handy if somebody is like, I'm having Wi-Fi issues. You can just kind of go and do a sanity check. I mean, overall, it works pretty much the same as any other cloud key. It seems far more serviceable. It's got redundant power supplies. It has actual IPMI. I can see somebody that has all of these devices, has a bunch of sites. Having just one giant cloud key instead of a bunch of little ones can be very attractive. It does seem to me, however, that maybe they should make a cloud key enterprise-ish, or a cloud key enterprise plus NVR. Maybe just like a normal ATX board size, just 1 gig, less money would be cool. It's probably overkill for you, and it certainly is for us, but I'm gonna put it in the rack anyways, and I hope you guys liked this video. So get subscribed. Oh man, if you could take the software on this thing and put it on one of those minis forum NUCs. I know you can get the Unify Network app and install it, but it's not really the same as the fully fledged Unify OS experience.